The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 4, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on February 27th, 1975, in Miami, Florida.
Now please hear my brief description of this field of activity and how it is constituted, what its changes are, whence it is produced, who that knower of the field of activities is, and what his influences are.
Jat chetram jatsa jadri jat vikari jatasya jat sacha ju jat prabhavasya tas samasena me sino. We have discussed that this body is the field of activity. We are acting according to the body. I am the same person, but when I had my boyhood body or childhood body, I was acting differently. This child, they are acting now somewhere, but when they will get another body, they will act in a different way. Similarly, not only this human form of body, but there are 8,400,000 different types of bodies. We have explained several times, jalajano lakhani, in the water there are 900,000 different forms of body. How many do we know? We do not know all the details. We know there are different types of fishes. And say 100,000 we have seen or experimented, the zoologist. But from the Vedic literature we understand that there are 900,000 forms of body within the water. So this is called Vedic knowledge. Perfect information is given there. Doesn't say 901 or 950, exactly 900,000. Jalajana valukkhani. Then next, Thavara lukkavinsati. Then after aquatic, when the water dries, the vegetation comes out, and that vegetation grow gradually into plants, trees, herbs, and so many big, big trees. Here we have got big, big trees. So from aquatic life, they have come to this vegetable life, and one tree standing for thousands of years. They cannot move an inch. This is also life. There is life. The trees, these banyan trees, they are making their arrangement, how to stand fixed up, very strong, nobody can move. The same struggle for existence is going on. As we are struggling to make our position secure, similarly the trees are also making their position secure. The cats and dogs, they are also making attempt to make their position secure. This is called struggle for existence. So, from this tree, just try to remember that there are 900,000 species of aquatics. We get information from Shastra, there is a fish which is called Timingal, which swallows big, big whales, just like big fish swallows a small fish. This is struggle for existence. Jiva-jivasya-jivanam, nunang mahatāna-tatra jiva-jivasya-jivanam. The natural law is that ahastanam sahastani, the animals which has no hands, that means four-legged animals, they have got legs, no hands. So they are food for animals with two legs and two hands. That means human being. Human being is also animal. More powerful, more intelligent than the lower animal. So the Shastra says, ahastani, the animals who haven't got hands, they are food for the animals with two hands. Ahastani sahastanam and apadani sapadanam. And the animals are the living entities which cannot move. Apadanam. Pada means legs, just like the trees, plants, grass. They cannot move. They have no legs. They have got legs, but they cannot move. They are eating through the legs. They are called padapa, meaning collecting water through the leg. Just these trees, they are drinking water from within the earth with their legs. Therefore they push their roots very deep to find out where is water. And if you put little water on the root of the tree, the leaf, they drink water. They're standing on the river side, drinking water and becoming very flourished. But although they are drinking the same water, still they are differently constituted. With different fruits, different flowers. This is God's creation. You have to understand that. Apadani sapadanam, apadani chatuspadam. Apadani means those who cannot move, these trees, plants, grass. They are eatables for the four-legged animals, chatuspadam. Chatu means four. Similarly, nunang mahatang tatra, those who are weak, they are food for the strong. That is going on. Might is right. The human society also, just like you Europeans, Americans, Europeans, they have come, you come to this land of America because you are strong, you are Vietnam, all the original inhabitants. So this is going on. This is called my struggle for existence. Therefore Krishna says, tat kshetraṁ jaccha jādrikṣa. Why we find so many varieties of life? How it has come into being? This everything is explained by Krishna. He says, tat samāsena me śrinu. From me you hear. Everyone is inquisitive. Why there are varieties of life? I do not know what the modern scientist says, but they do not understand that there is soul in these different types of body. That we have already discussed. That idam sariram kshetram iti abhidhiyate, every different particular living entity. Not particularly, we are all living entities, part and parcel of God. But we have entered into different types of bodies according to our desire. That's it. We have got desires, different types of desires. The 8,400,000 bodies means at least we have got 8,400,000 different types of desires. That we have to learn from power authorities like Krishna. Therefore he says, tas samasena mesinu. You try to understand. You cannot speculate. Is there any psychologist who can say how many different types of thinking, feeling, feelings are there? No. They cannot say. But we must know from Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, that these 8,400,000 species or forms of life are there because there are 8,400,000 different types of deserts. Exactly 8,400,000. This is called Vedic knowledge. Exactly what is the fact that is stated there. So our process of understanding this Krishna consciousness movement, we do not hear from any bogus person. We hear from Krishna. Therefore Krishna said for us, those who are Krishna consciousness, tat samasena me sinu, from me. Because I am the supreme authority, Krishna. Krishna says that mattav paratanam nanya kinchi jasti dhanaya. There is no more superior authority than me. So we get knowledge from superior authority. That is the process of acquiring knowledge. We go to school, colleges, teachers. So, why? To receive knowledge. The teacher or school, college, they are in higher authority. Similarly, you go on higher authorities, you reach to Brahma. Because he is the original creature and he described the Vedic knowledge. So he is also not a higher authority. He also received knowledge from God. Tene brahmarida adhikavai, that is stated in the Srimad Bhagavata. Adhikavai, the original person. We have got this body expanding. The original person is Brahma. From Brahma there was Lord Shiva, and from Shiva there were so many, then the Dakhas, and Prachetasas, and many sages gradually, so we are descended. Manu also one of the sons of Brahma. And from Manu, the name has come Manusha. Manusha means man. In English also it is called man. Manu, man. So we are all descendants from the original person, the Supreme Father. Original. So we are not different. Here we have created out of ignorance. I am Indian, you are European, he is American, he is African, he is black, he is white. That we have created. He is cat, he is dog. But actually, we are all living entities. Because we have got different types of desires, and that is calculated. 8,400,000 types of desires. So we are now in different types of body. This is understanding. Samasarveshu bhuteshu. So when we get that spiritual knowledge, Brahma bhuta prasannatma, then there is no difference. A learned person who has realized Brahma, spiritual realization, he looks everyone on the equal level. He knows that it is a dog or it is a cat on account of this body. He is neither cat, neither dog, neither a human being. We are all spirit soul. Aham Brahmasmi. This is understand. This is real understand. Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmani gavi hastini suni cheta sapati cha pandita samadarshana. Those are learned. They see that here is a learned brahmin, and here is a dog, and here is a hawk, and he's a dog eater. There is an elephant. There is a cow. So they are in different dresses only, and the real occupier of the dress or the body, that is explained. Idam shariram kaunteya. What is that? Idam shariram kaunteya kshetram iti avidya. This is only, we have got, according to different desires, we have got these different types of body. Kshetra, that's like field. The cultivator, the farmer, works on the field and gets some result. Similarly, we have got different types of body and you are working on this body and bodily concepts of life. Not advanced life. If we are in the bodily concept of life, that is animal life. When we understand that I know that I am not this body, I am working with this body, that is not. Abhijiyate. And not only I, one should understand. It is clearly stated here, there is no difficulty. Krishna said that the living entity and myself, we are both within this body. Khetram kanchapi manabindhi sarva khetresu. The difference, we are individuals also. We are living, every one of us living within this body. And there is another body, another living entity. God is also a living entity like you and me. The difference is that He is great and we are subordinate. Otherwise, just like you have got your president, he is a big man of your nation, and we are a small man or you are a small man. But he is also a human being, I am also a human being or you are also. Similarly, God is exactly like us, with two hands and two legs. If you see Krishna, he hasn't got 100 legs or 100. He has got the same, two legs and two hands. Exactly like our body. In the Bible also says, I think, that man is made after the feature of God. So it is not that we have imagined God with two legs and two hands like us. No. This body is made imitating God's body. The animals, they are also imitating God's body. God has got many forms. Advaita acyuta anadi ananta rupam. Adyam purana purusam navajoga. He has got many other forms, innumerable. So anyway, this is knowledge that I am occupying this body, I have got this body according to my desire, and this desire has been fulfilled by God. God is with me, with you. He is within your heart. He understands what you desire. You have come, we have come in this material world to satisfy our different desires. Therefore, there are so many different forms of body. Now you can calculate also. What is that? There are three qualities within this material. You know everyone. Some are in goodness, and some are in passion, and some are in ignorance. In the animal, or in the vegetable kingdom, in the human society, we find these three types of men. Take our human society. Some of them are very good men, very truthful, very honest, very learned, and knows what is God. We find such men also. And we'll find also very much passionate. And you will find also men like cats and dogs. No knowledge, blind. So there are three types of men. Why? Because there are three good qualities or modes of material nature. Goodness, passion, and ignorance. Now you mix up these three qualities with another three varieties of qualities, just like the painter. They mix up different colors. The original color is blue, yellow, and red. Now you mix up these colors, you can hundreds and thousands of colors you can make. It requires expert handling. Similarly, originally these three qualities, goodness, passion, and ignorance. Now 3 × 3 = 9, and 9 × 9 = 81. So we get immediately account for 81 varieties, and each variety is thousands and millions, therefore 8,400,000 is calculated, and we have got so many varieties of life. Jalayano lokkhani sabra lokkhavinsati kirmayo rudra sankhaka means the aquatics, there are 900,000, and the trees and plants, 2,000,000, and 1,100,000, these flies and insects, kimayo rudra sankhaka, and then birds, 1,000,000 types of birds, then 3,000,000 types of bees, then 400,000 of human beings, civilized, uncivilized, white, red, black, so many varieties. In this way, the whole calculation is 8,400,000 different types of body. Now Krishna will explain that tat khetram jatya jati, why there are so many varieties. The living entity is the same, the spiritual spark, part and parcel of Krishna or God. But why they have assumed these different types of body calculated to be 8,400,000 forms. But each form is part and parcel of God. Not each form, or you can say form also, each living entity. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Sarvajoni sukonti or sambhamanti murtayoja. Tasang mahajani brahma aham bija padapita. Krishna says, I think in the 14th chapter it is there, that I am the seed-giving father of all these forms of life. All these forms of life. They are not, automatically come from anywhere. I am the original father. Therefore, those who are fully Krishna conscious, are fully advanced in spiritual consciousness, they do not make any difference between an insect and an agent. Because he knows very well that the same spirit soul is there within the elephant and within the insect, within the microbe, because the dimension of the spirit soul is very small. You cannot even imagine. It is 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair. Isākura satubhāgasya satubhākulpita. Everything is there. So such minute particle is so powerful that it is managing the body of the elephant and it is managing the body of the ant. We find even an ant, he has got all the propensities, just like human beings. You can study how they are struggling, how they have organized their society, how they are eating, how they are sleeping, how they are begetting children. Everything is there, namely life. Four principles of bodily demands, namely eating, sleeping, sex, and defense, we find in the insect, smallest insect, like fullstop. I sometimes see at night, they wander on the page of the book, very small, but they have got all the purpose. all the propensities. We can study. Anyone minute study can see. So these things are there, everywhere. Even to the ant or even to the elephant or to the demigod or any Brahma or anything. That is clear. So when we get, by evolutionary process, come to this human form of life, by God's grace, nature's mercy, we can understand what is what. Therefore Krishna is explaining to Arjuna a human being, not to a cat and dog. Therefore he says, tat khetra, that body, how it has become, varieties. What is the ingredients? The ingredients are the same. This material body, the ingredients are the four primary gross elements, means earth, water, air, fire, and ether or sky, the mind, intelligence and ether. This is the composition of this body. And beyond this composition, I am there. So, Indrani, Para, Rahu, those are in the bodily concept of life, they are thinking, the senses are everything. So let us enjoy the senses. That is our happiness. No. That is not, therefore you are not happy actually. Although we are trying to gratify our senses profusely, still we are unhappy. Because that is not actually happiness. The actual happiness is of the soul. Unless you satisfy the soul, you cannot be happy. Because my real identity is the soul, not this body. The same example as I have already said many times, that within the cage there is the bird. You don't take care of the bird and you simply cleanse this cage, the bird will not be satisfied. He'll cry always, give me food, give me food. Another example I gave you, another psychiatrist, that this body is a machine. Actually it is a machine. And it is being driven by two persons. One is God and one is a living entity, individual. The God is giving direction. The living entity, individual soul, wants to enjoy. So he is on the carriage, same carriage. The super soul and the soul. So the super soul knows what I want to enjoy, and he is giving facility. Oh, you want this facility? Now drive your car in this way. You want this facility? All right, drive this way, this way. Actually, super soul or God does not want, but he is so kind, just like a gentleman, he gives the dog all facility, sometimes going this side, sometimes going this side, sometimes passing stool, sometimes crossing wheel, and he's standing. He is controlling, but he is giving some facility. This dog is my servant, I am blessing him. This is going on. Without God's sanction, we cannot do anything. Then why does He give sanction for our sinful activities? Because we want to do it. Because we want to do it. God does not want that you become implicated in sinful life. Therefore He steals very still. God says from Him, don't steal. He'll be implicated. He'll be arrested. He'll be punished. Why you are stealing? But He will do. He'll do. That is obvious. That is ignorance. God is always helping us. But we do not care for God. That is our disease. Therefore, we are getting different types of body and suffering. This is the philosophy, real philosophy. That God is there with me. In the same body, in the sense exactly the same. Then the driver is there, and the proprietor is there in the same car. The car is a machine. Similarly, this body is a machine. It is stated in the Bhagavad Gita machine. Jantra rurani maya. Ishara sarvabhutana riddhese vajjuna tishtati maya brahmayan sarvabhutani jantra rurani maya. Ishara, the Supreme Lord, God, is situated in everyone's heart. He is directing the trouble or wandering of the living entity. How? Jantra Rurani sitting on the machine of this body. And who has supplied the machine? Maya, the material nature. The material nature, according to the order of God, has given me, you or me or anyone, the cat's dog, etc. particular type of machine, this body, and the living entity is driving the machine or driving the car, and God, the super soul, is reminding him, you wanted to enjoy like this, now you drive your car in this way. You drive it. You wanted to eat everything without any discrimination, now I have given you the car of a hog. Now you go and eat this too. And he's very glad. He's enjoying. He's enjoying. He's thinking, I'm eating very nice thing. This is going on. Nana joni bhraman kare kadajya bhakkhan kare tara janma adhukpate ja. Narottam Das Thakur is singing that those who have taken this path of fruitive activities, they are forced to accept different forms of life and eat all abominable things, and thus he is lost in this native life. So, if we become God-conscious, if we become faithful to Krishna, our God, then he will give right direction so that you may go again back to home, back to God. And that is all. Tisham satatu yuktanam bhajatana priti purvatam dadami buddhi yogam tam jenamam upajanti. Now, according to my wings, according to my defined desires, I am going deep and deep to the hellish condition of life. I am becoming the wands of this tool, beginning from Brahma. When we have got this human form of life, we should understand how things are happening, how I am getting different types of body, how I am dictated according to the body, and I am not happy. Now, what is the reason? Then what I am? I do not want distress. Why distress is forced upon me? I do not want to die. Why death is forced upon me? I do not want to become old. I want to remain perpetually young. Why old age is forced upon me? There are so many things. In this way, when we become intelligent enough and approach Krishna or Krishna's representative, then our life becomes reformed. This Krishna consciousness movement is for this purpose. They are giving the opportunity to the human society that you are suffering on account of your whimsical desires. Now you learn how to purify your desires. Then you become happy. This is Krishna consciousness. Desire cannot be stopped. That is not possible. You have to purify your desire. That's all. Sarvapadi vininmuktam tatparatena nirmalam. I am thinking that I am this American, I am thinking I am this Indian, or I am thinking this and that. I am creating my desires accordingly. It is my duty because I am American. It is my duty because I am Russian. So let us fight. So this is going on. So you have to change your desire. That is Krishna consciousness. Sarvapadhi minanmuktam. You have to understand that I am not this body. I'm neither Indian nor American nor Russian. I'm part and parcel of God. Therefore my business is to serve God. This is called bhakti. When you are self-realized, that is definition of bhakti. Sarva upadhi vinin muktam. You have to get yourself cleansed from all this dazingness. That I am Hindu, I am Muslim, I am Christian, I am American, I am this, I am that, I am God. These are all designations, because I am pure soul, I am Brahmasmi. And these conceptions are designations. So you have to be educated how to become free from the designation. That is, sarvupadhikinin muktam tatparatina nirmala. That when we become free from the designation, it does not mean because I become free from the designation, therefore I become zero. No, I remain, because I am spirit soul, eternal. I may become sometimes American, sometimes Indian, sometimes cat, sometimes dog, but that is change of designation or body. But as spirit soul, I am eternal. Na jayati, na mriyati, va. Kadachit na hannate hannamane sarire. These things are all clearly stated. So, our request is that all over the world, they should take advantage of this knowledge. This Krishna consciousness movement is not a bluffing movement. It is a scientific movement for the benefit of the whole world. They are suffering. So that is our request. Let us wash ourselves from the dizziness. Then how it will be possible? It will be possible. What is that? Sinnatāṁ sabathā krishna punnat-savanakīvam riddhantasya avadhyāni vidhunati suhitsatāṁ riddhantasya-avadhyāni. This I am thinking American, Indian, Hindu, Muslim. This is all dirty things in my heart. It cleans your heart. Riddham tasta avadran. The dirty things are within my heart. So if we cleanse our heart, then we become free from this designation. Nashta prayesu avadresu. Nittana bhagavata sevaya. Nashta praya. These dirty things will be cleansed if we regularly hear Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam or Bhagavad Gita. Nityana-Bhāgavata. And Bhāgavata means the book Bhāgavata and the person Bhāgavata. The person Bhāgavata is spiritual master. Or any exalted devotee is Mahābhāgavata-Bhāgavata. So Bhāgavata-Sivaya means not only reading Bhagavad Gita or Bhāgavatam, but we have to study from the person Bhagavata. That is required. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu advised, Bhagavata parogya Bhagavata sthane. If you want to learn Bhagavata, then go to the person Bhagavata who is realized so. Not professional. That will not help you. Official professional, I go to a temple, to church, and go back again. To his condition or no. We just associate with the person Bhagavata, with realized soul, and hear from him this the same book, the same knowledge. Krishna supreme, just like Krishna says, Tasamasena, Mesuna. Mesuna. Hear from me. Or my representative. Then you benefit. So these centers are being opened just to give the opportunity to the people who are suffering, not only in this life, life after life. Eirupe brahmanda bhamite kono bhagavane ji guru krishna kripa paya bhakti vata. So it is our duty, we are taking this duty on behalf of Krishna. Krishna personally comes to teach, just like he left his Srimad Bhagavatam. Then he entrusts his devotees to explain to the people in general We are attempting to do that. We have not manufactured anything, or you have got anything of our own. The asset and the property is there. We are simply distributing as peon. That's all. And we have no difficulty. It is simply present. Bhagavad Gita is instruction of Krishna as it is. Then our duty finished. We have not to manufacture anything. Neither we have power to manufacture anything. Just like there are so many others, they manufacture new type of ideas, new type of things, all nonsense. That will not help. Take the real knowledge. Try to understand from the Supreme Personality of Godhead, or the real servant of Godhead. We'll present simply what Krishna says. He'll not say anything more or less. That is the identification of real servant. Like you have got a servant, you say, oh, my dear boy, you go. This servant informed me this. So his duty is to carry your news and deliver to the person. Similarly, we who are now in the Krishna consciousness movement, we should simply take tasamasena maestro. We should hear from Krishna and distribute this knowledge. We have no difficulty. Then those who will hear, they will be benefited and we will. This is Krishna consciousness movement. Thank you very much.